Bankstown Art Society is a non-profit organisation and managed by volunteers.
There's so much to learn. You just go on and on and on learning.
How many paintings have you done in your life, do you think?
You've only got to look around this house.
The public are quite liberty to walk in while we're here at classes and to have a look around, to look at our gallery in here, and also to just have a peek in at the class and perhaps think, oh, I'd like to do that and join the Bankstown Art Society. There's no pressure put on them. As if they want to do some form of art.
We also have artists or people who join, not classes, just for the sake of being able to hang their paintings in the gallery.
Because this was a classroom, and the Art Society has put lights in and tracking and all that so that we could turn it into a gallery.
This year we'll have an art exhibition at the library, Bankstown Library, and that gives a chance to the artists to display a part of their work. So we have the art classes for adults and children. During the week.
The committee has become bigger and bigger, and we now have a full-time social secretary who arranges bus trips, train trips and boat trips to Manly, up the river on the River Cat. We also organise car trips where we just get enough cars together to carry the people that want to go, and we head off on places where the trains don't run.
If someone's never painted before and are interested, what should they do?
Come and join Bankstown Art Society, of course. What else? Now, a lot of people do like to, or they don't understand how to mix colours. They don't know blue and yellow makes green, etc., things like that. That's how I started off. I wanted to learn how to mix colours and what colours you could use. We're a very, very friendly society. We mix very well, actually, I think. There's no squabbles anywhere.
Yes, I certainly do wish them every success. I really appreciate getting their bulletins every month, and I very much like the idea of their participating in this Art of Sydney competition, and other things like that to spread themselves out a little bit. I do congratulate them in how far they've come, and I can sincerely hope that they continue on from there.
We started with a group that called themselves Bankstown Art Group, and they were in existence between 1953 and 1957. In 1958, they attended an art course that was run in Bankstown, and at the end of the art course, 16 of them decided it was a good venture and they would like to continue. So they advertised in the local papers, and in August 1958, they formed with 16 members. They were meeting and painting then in the scaffold in Appian Way, and that continued until 1975 when the council bought a building on the corner of Meredith Street and North Terrace. The building was turned over to people in Bankstown who had arts and crafts and various interests as a meeting room. Bankstown Art Society continued there until 1989 when the council completed a new building on the old swimming pool premises, and it was turned over to arts and crafts, namely the Bankstown Art Society, the Lapidus Club and the Theatrical Society.
But it's interesting. It's a challenge.
Yeah.
You know, it really is a challenge all the time, and I do think as you get older, it helps the brain to keep a little bit active. Just keep going. I mean, look how many years I've been going. And I still enjoy it and still go to the class, and you know, you have such nice friends, and something to think about. I look forward to my class of a Thursday, as I always did at Bankstown.
It's a self-expression. It's very creative. You get a lot of self-enjoyment from it. You can get confidence, self-esteem, and when people say your artwork's good, it makes you feel better.
We have it every quarter. We have the Four Seasons Awards, and that's to encourage people attending classes to exhibit their work, because people won't exhibit, they're too scared. But with this, they don't have to have a price, they don't have to be for sale, all they have to be is able to be hung. And we give a prize every quarter. We have one of our tutors judge the exhibition, and then we have the most popular person's painting voted for it. And I think that's encouraged people to go on further and exhibit in other art things. We have a system here where we've been taking our members' artworks out to other exhibitions, like, for instance, Tumut, Kutamandra, and also we've come up with quite a few prizes through entering these country exhibitions.
We have two exhibitions a year. We have our annual exhibition in our gallery, and once a year we go to Bankstown Square, where we offer paintings to the public for viewing and for sale. Some years we do quite well at Bankstown. We've sold between 20 and 30 paintings at Bankstown Square, which is a joy to the members. Nobody really knows how well they paint until they've sold a painting. Gives them heart to go on and a bit of money to buy some more paintbrushes.